Contextual navigations enable a seamless transition from identifying issues to resolving them. The main intention of a contextual navigation is to pass a filter from a source component to a target component, SAP GUI system, or web app to analyze data and gain more insights. By using contextual navigations and applying meaningful filters, you can achieve better performance. Today, we will explore the features available as of 2505 and the use cases they can address. At first, we have a look at how to create a contextual navigation. We switch to design mode and right-click any cell in the planning view and choose Create Contextual Navigation. You can also create navigations from analytics charts or master data views. The wizard will guide you through the process of creating the navigation. The wizard is also accessible for existing navigations. In this workbook, several navigations have already been defined. Let's continue exploring them instead of creating new ones. In general, there are two ways to access the wizard. You can find the defined contextual navigations in the side panel. Here you can also delete the navigations. In the side panel you can find all navigations that are valid for the component in question. It may be the case that one navigation is marked as not applicable. Such navigations are hidden from the component automatically. We will have another look at why this may be the case at a later point in time. For the second option to open the wizard, right-click on the desired data point and then select the navigation. If the target component is not assigned to the workbook, you'll be asked whether you want to edit the contextual navigation or the target component. In this case, we want to edit the navigation. Now let's have a look at our first navigation. The planning view at hand contains information about the planned demand fulfillment. As a next step, we want to understand from which plants the distribution centers are being supplied. In the first step, we can define the navigation target. We can select from Component in the current workbook, any component, or External Navigation. Component in the current workbook allows you to navigate to a component that is already assigned to the workbook. The downside of this option is that data for the component is requested every time you open the workbook or apply the workbook filter, rather than only when you actually need it. Hence, our examples use any component. In this case, we can navigate to an existing component. Finally, there's the option External Navigation. You can use this option in case you defined a navigation in the Manage Navigation to Other Systems app. Make sure you have selected Planner Workspaces, Contextual Navigation, for Available in. Otherwise, the navigation won't show up in the Contextual Navigation wizard. In general, we recommend that you replace navigations defined as Planner Workspace, Planning View. By using contextual navigations, you control the conditions under which the navigation is available. External navigations allow you to navigate to other SAP IBP apps, the SAP GUI, or any other URL. For example, you can navigate to PPDS applications. The next two parameters are meant to define to which component we want to navigate. In step 2, we can define the name of the contextual navigation. Additionally, we can define where the contextual navigation should be available. If you stick to the default, the navigation will be available only in this component. If you select Workbook or Workspace, you can reuse the navigation in other components as well. The navigation will only show up if the navigation requirements are met. We will have a look at this in the next step. The Placement option allows you to define where the target component will be added. You choose whether the navigation will be placed below or next to the source component or on a new tab. In step 3, we define the navigation requirements. The attribute selection here has two meanings. All the attributes marked as mandatory need to be added to the navigation context. If one of the mandatory attributes is missing, the navigation will not show up. Remember that we talked about the not applicable token in the side panel and the available in options previously? Now we can connect the dots. Coming back to the mandatory attributes, those will be also used to define the filter. Attributes marked as optional will not be passed to the target component. In this example, the product group, customer ID, and the time period are marked as optional. As a next step, we can define for which key figure the navigation should show up. If you disable this option, the navigation will show up for every key figure displayed. In many cases, it makes sense to restrict the list though. In the next step, we define the filter behavior. This checkbox allows you to pass not only the context of the selected combination, but also the filters defined for the source component. For instance, it may be the case that you defined a customer group filter, but you didn't add this attribute to the source component. If you enable this checkbox, the customer group filter will be passed to the target component as well. If the checkbox is disabled, only the mandatory attributes will be passed to the target component. The next option allows you to define whether the component filter should be applied as well. For instance, you can define that only data of a specific location type should be displayed in the target component. To achieve this, you define the component filter accordingly and select this option. On top of that, you can define attributes mappings, or you can even look up filter values by using master data. We skip this topic for now and will come back later. In the last step, we can review the setup again. Now we can trigger the navigation. As you can see, the new component got added. We can verify the applied filters here. Now that we know the basics about contextual navigations, we can have a look at more advanced examples. We continue with an example that uses attribute mappings. The planning view contains the ship from location ID, which we want to pass to the next planning view as location ID. Let's open the wizard again. Remember that the wizard is only accessible in design mode. In step 3, only the ship from location ID is selected. In step 4, we can define the attribute mapping. We simply map the ship from location ID to the location ID. Now we can trigger the navigation. As you can see, the location ID got applied as a filter. Without the mapping, we would apply ship from location ID as a filter. As a result, no data could be displayed. The next example is about using master data to determine the applied filters. Before we can open the contextual navigation wizard, we need to trigger another navigation, which will show us the bill of material. In step 4, the master data type, production source resource, is selected. We use the source ID from the source component to look up the resource ID in the master data type given above. As a result, we will identify all resources that are assigned to the provided source ID. Here's how the master data set looks like. Now we can trigger the navigation and check the applied filter once again. Now you know the most important aspects of contextual navigations. Consider adding only the components that you need to get started to a workbook. Add additional components on the go by using contextual navigations. In addition, users don't need to worry about defining filters when navigating from one component to another, as filters are part of the contextual navigation definition.